بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على رسوله الكريم، أما بعد، أهلا ومرحبا بكم في حلقة جديدة من برنامج Arabic True Stories.
Hey guys, welcome back to another video of Arabic True Stories Level 2. اسمي عبد الله.
جميل. اليوم نبدأ بدرس أو بقصة جديدة. We're going to start with a new story.
Story
2. طيب. So we're going to do the same activity. First read. I will read once. أنا أقرأ أولا. ثم تقرأ. ثم نحلل. نحلل. Solve. ثم نحلل الكلمات. طيب. جاهز؟
جاهز.
جاهز. Okay. طيب. القصة: السمكة والشبكة. سمكة صغيرة في النهر قالت لنفسها: أريد أن آكل، أبحث عن طعام. رأت دودة، فرحت وقالت: هذا طعام لذيذ. فتحت فمها وذهبت نحو الدودة، ولكن سمكة كبيرة بلعت الدودة. ما هذا؟ آه! السمكة الكبيرة خرجت من الماء. أخذت السمكة الصغيرة تسبح من جديد. رأت فتاة الخبز يسقط في الماء، فتحت فمها وذهبت نحو الخبز. صاحت السمكة: آه! الشبكة حبستني، الشبكة حبستني. أمي حذرتني من الطعم، أمي حذرتني من الشبكة. يا خسارة، يا خسارة، يا خسارة. وعلى القارب فتح الصياد الشبكة، جمع السمك الكبير ورمى السمك الصغير في الماء. فهمت؟ أريد أن تريد أن تقرأ؟ You want to read؟
نعم.
طيب نبدأ. بسم الله.
سمكة صغيرة.
السمكة.
السمكة صغيرة.
انظر هناك واو. السمكة.
السمكة والشبكة.
والشبكة. You stop it. No need to read the timer, but if you stop.
سمكة صغيرة.
See, you're continuing
السمكة
here.
السمكة.
No, see, notice. When you're continuing, read the Tamil Buddha. سمكة صغيرة. If you stop, with the ha.
السمكة صغيرة.
There's no as.
No.
سمكة.
سمكة صغيرة.
سمكة صغيرة.
سمكة صغيرة في النهر.
Very good.
قالت لنفسها: أريد أن آكل، أبحث عن طعام. رأت دودة، فرحت وقالت.
فرحت.
فرحت وقالت: هذا طعام لذيذ.
طعام لذيذ.
طعام لذيذ.
نعم، لذيذ.
لذيذ. فتحت فمها وذهبت نحو الدودة.
نحو الدودة.
نحو الدودة.
طيب، جميل، ممتاز.
ولكن سمكة كبيرة بلعت الدودة.
نعم، سمكة كبيرة بلعت الدودة. جميل، you read very nice. ولكن
ما هذا؟ السمكة.
السمكة.
السمكة الكبيرة خرجت من الماء. أخذت السمكة الصغيرة. الصغيرة تسبح من جديد. رأت فتاة
الخبز. It's one word.
فتاة الخبز يسقط في الماء.
ممتاز.
فتحت فمها وذهبت نحو
خبز.
نحو الخبز.
ممتاز.
صاحت السمكة.
السمكة.
السمكة. الشبكة حبستني. الشبكة حبستني. أمي هادتني. حذرتني من الطعام.
من الطعام.
من الطعام. طعم.
أمي حذرتني.
حذرتني من الشبكة.
شبكة.
يا خسارة. يا خسارة. يا خسارة. وعلى القارب. وعلى القارب فتح الصياد الشبكة. جمع السمكة الكبيرة. الكبيرة. ورمى السمكة الصغيرة.
السمكة الصغيرة.
السمكة الصغيرة في الماء.
في الماء. الحمد لله. Very nice. Very nice. So, before we analyze, I noticed that Abdullah is pronouncing, for example, Al Samaka. So, we had not discussed about this before. In Arabic, there are how many alphabets, how many letters are there in the Arabic alphabet, Abdullah? Al Ta'rif? Do you know?
26.
26 fil English. In English. Like in fil Arabiya? 28.
28?
28.
Wait, isn't it
27 in English? No, 26. Okay, you don't need to count. 28 letters in the Arabic alphabet. These letters are categorized into two groups. The first group are called as sun letters, and the second group are called as moon letters. Did you know that?
No.
Sun letters come from sun, and moon letters come from moon. No, I'm just kidding. Why do we call them sun letters and moon letters? Okay, very interesting. So, there is a whole category of them, but I will give you a simple rule. Okay, why do you need to know them? Because if it is a sun letter, then you should not pronounce the lam in an. Okay.
Also, as-samakatu.
As-samakatu.
As-sayyar. As-sayyar.
As-sayyar. If it is a moon letter, then you must pronounce the lam. So, which of these are moon letters and which of these are sun letters? Okay. So there's a whole category of them, but the easy way to remember is take the lam as your main letter. Okay? Observe where the letter lam comes from. Makhraj. Makhraj in Arabic means a place where something comes. Okay? So, where is the makhraj of lam? Abdullah, is it behind, near the throat, in front of the mouth, near the mouth? Where is it?
It's like in the front, in the tip of the tongue.
Tip of the tongue, meaning somewhere very close. Okay?
Yeah.
So, a very simple rule is that if the letter that comes after lam is close to the place where lam comes from, then we say that is the sun letter, or usually it will fall into the sun letter. Okay? So, look at sheen. Is it behind or front?
Oh, so it's a shabaka?
A shabaka.
A shabaka is a moon letter. No.
Sun letter, because it's closer to the place where the lamb is coming from. Okay?
Yeah.
And
something got mixed up.
And let's take some examples.
Al-Kitab. That's a
Al-Kitab. So it's calf.
Moon letter.
Yeah, moon letter, exactly. See, mashallah, you got it. So the calf is a little bit behind, right? It comes just in front of the throat.
Calf.
Al-Maktab. And Mim also is outside. It's not inside where the lamb is. Al-Maktab.
It's near the...
Yeah, but it's outside. Top. Outside this one. So wherever it is closer to the thing, it becomes far. It has to be near the tongue and tip of the tongue. If those letters are closer to that, then those most likely will be under the sun letters.
So it's So al-maktab is a
moonlight.
Moonlight
yeah
as well.
yeah very good. Okay, so for example, bab, al-bab, you have to pronounce lam. Okay, but if it is ta, okay, for example, at-ta'am, at-ta'am, lam and ta are close, so that is
sunlight.
Okay, so you don't need to go in and memorize these letters, just go with the flow, as they say, right? So if the letter is very close to lam, then it is most likely to be sun letter, and if it is not, then it is moon letter. So we call them al-huruf al-shamsiyya. Al-huruf means letters. Shamsiyya means what? Shams. What is shams?
Shams is sun.
Sun. So we say al-huruf al-shamsiyya, meaning sun letters. Al-huruf al-qamariyya, meaning moon letters. Qamar means moon. Al-huruf al-qamariyya, al-huruf al-shamsiyya. Okay? So try not to make the mistake. Try to remember the rule. So don't say al-samaka, as-samaka. Okay? So that's the extra thing today.
Ash-shabaka.
Ash-shabaka. Very good. Okay. So now let's go back and analyze the story. As-samaka, anta tarif. As-samaka, anta tarif. Mamana as-samaka? As-samaka, what is samaka? Mamana, mamana
means what? Fish.
Fish. Was-shabaka?
Net.
Net. طيب, nahnu darasna fil juz al-awwal or fil marhalat al-ula. We learned that in first level, right? Darasna as-samaka was-shabaka. Both we learned. طيب. سمكة صغيرة في النهر. ما معنى هذه الجملة؟ معنى means meaning. جملة means sentence. ما معنى هذه الجملة؟ سمكة صغيرة في النهر.
The small fish was in the
river.
نهر.
Okay. Abdullah said the small fish. So you must pay attention now. Is it the small fish? Does it say as-samakatu? A small fish. That's how the story begins, right? No one knows. So you're beginning with a small fish in the then it becomes as-samaka next time. Okay? Because first time when you're speaking, you don't know which fish. You're talking about some fish. So you start with a nakira. We learned in the past nakira is indefinite. So we say unspecific, as Abdullah likes to call it. So samakatun sagiratun fil nahar. So there's nothing new over here, we know it. And nahar is a new word, which means river. Mm-hmm. Sounds like river.
Nahar,
river.
River.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So samakatun sagiratun fil nahar. Tayyib. Qalat li nafsiha. Qalat. Nahnu na'rif ma ma'na qalat. Qalat said. Remember you look at
nafsi has to self.
To self, yeah. Li, see. So qalat, notice that it has a tamar, ta sukun, because it's a it's a fish which is a girl, right? Qalat li nafsiha. And qalat requires the harf jar connecting word li. So if I say aqulu laka, see I use the word, I'm saying this to you. Or qultu laka. Okay? So laka, lam is used always with qalat. So qalat li nafsiha.
If it was a boy, then it would be qala.
Qala li nafsihi.
Nafsihi.
Okay, very good. Nafsihi is, use it as a phrase, a very nice phrase to remember. So you can say, Qultu li nafsi. I told to myself. Okay, how do you say I told myself? Qultu.
Qultu.
Li.
Li nafsi.
Li nafsi.
Li nafsi. Yeah.
Okay? طيب. Uridu an akul. Very easy. We learned this. Uridu an akula. What does it mean? Uridu an.
Oh, I want food.
I want to.
I want to.
See, an is two.
Oh,
remember,
I
don't
want
forget
to
that.
Eat.
I want to eat. So, if notice, it's an. So, that means you always with uridu. If you want to do something, then after uridu, you will have to use an. Okay? You say, uridu an adhaba. Uridu an akula. Uridu an aktuba. Uridu an ashraba. Okay? Always uridu an. You have to put together if you have, if you want to do something. Tayyib. أبحث عن طعام. What is أبحث عن طعام?
He looked for
Notice the words on the letters. أبحث. He looked,
he saw.
But is it what he or I or he or she?
She saw.
Why? What is the sign of she or here? أبحث. نعم. أبحث. So what is أبحث. What is, what says it is she? Hamza, man. Hamza says what?
Oh, أبحثو.
What is Hamza in the beginning of a verb, mudariya, say? Who's doing it? أبحثو.
أبحثو. I?
Yeah.
So
أبحثو عن طعام.
I went.
It's mudariya, present tense, right?
I looked.
Not looked. أبحثو عن. Remember, we said this in story one. أتش الغراب شديدة فأخذ يبحث عن ماء.
Look for.
Yeah. This one is I look for.
Look for a food.
Yeah, food. Okay. So don't forget what you learned in story one.
So story one's for the crow is thirsty.
Yeah, and he was looking for water. Yeah.
Is a fish.
Very nice. Yeah, very good.
Looking for food.
Looking for food.
But it's harder for the fish to find food.
Nah. Let's see.
Fish
رأت دودة. رأت دودة. دودة means
earthworm.
Okay. رأت. رأت means
found.
Saw. More correct. Saw. وجد is found. That we learned in story one. وجد الغراب جرة قديمة. Over here, رأت. Saw.
رأت
دودة.
Saw.
نعم. ماذا فعلت؟ What did it do afterward؟
فرحت.
فرحت.
وقالت. She's the فريحة said هذا طعام.
No, فريحت. So do you think فريحة is the name of the fish? No, فريحت means it became happy. That's why some people have the name Fariha, Farhan. All of these is from the same sound, Fariha. Then it's a name. Here, it notice. So if there's a tasukun, right? If there's a tasukun, it's a verb.
So your name.
Khalas, you don't need to think twice.
Your name is happy.
No, she's happy.
She is happy.
Yeah, she's a happy one. Or if it is Fariha.
And her name.
Farhan means he's happy.
What about her name?
Yeah, it has her name. So in this case, her name is Fariha.
So that means she's happy and her name is Happy Tempi.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. So, but over here, this is almost like a rule you can take. If you see ta sukun at the end of a word, and it's almost likely to be a verb. Okay, farihat means she was happy.
So that's kind. Happy is an adjective.
Yeah. Farihat, وقالت. ماذا قالت؟
هذا طعام لذيذ.
نعم, this is an easy one, right? We learn هذا طعام لذيذ, هذا كتاب جديد, هذا مكتب جديد, هذا كرسي جديد, أنت ولد جديد. Are you next? Okay?
No.
So it's very simple. هذا طعام لذيذ. لذيذ means yummy.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. ماذا فعلت بعد ذلك? What did you do afterward? ماذا فعلت السمكة بعد ذلك
فتحت فمها وذهب نحو الدودة.
ذهبت. Don't forget this.
ذهبت نحو الدودة.
نحو الدودة. فتحت. ما معنى فتحت؟
فتحت.
فتح.
فتح فمها. فتح فمها وذهب.
فتحت. Remember what do we call, why do we call سورة الفاتحة?
Began?
Yeah, to begin or open something. Okay? So, what did it open? Famaha.
It's mouth?
Mouth, yeah. Fatahat famaha.
That's it has.
Yes, yeah, exactly. Very good.
Maskun.
Mashallah, you should observe those things. Fatahat famaha. Thumma fa'alat mada. What did it do? Yeah, exactly. You need to observe. Arabic is all about observation. The rules come later on. We don't even care about rules right now. Okay. فتحت فمها ثم فعلت ماذا? What did you do afterwards?
went towards
نعم ذهبت نحو الدولة. نحو
is direction.
The direction of. Okay, you just learn the word. Okay, نحبت in the direction of. So it will always be إضافة. نحو الدودة. So if you say أذهب نحو المسجد, I go in the direction of the masjid.
Or I pray in the direction of the Kaaba.
Yeah. You can say that. Yeah, sure. And then you say, for example, سمعت صوتا. I heard a sound. وذهبت نحو الصوت. Oh. I went in the direction of the sound. Sound and sound the same. Okay.
The same word.
Yeah, almost the same. Yeah, almost the same till the end. طيب. Let's move on. ولكن. Now, remember we used ولكن in level, we learned in chapter in level 1. ولكن means but. Okay. But what happened? Was it able to eat? هل يستطيع أو هل تستطيع السمكة أن تأكل? Was the fish able to eat? الدودة السمكة الصغيرة.
لا.
لا لماذا؟
الكبيرة
السمكة كبيرة
كبيرة بلعت الدودة.
نعم قبل أن تأكل before the small fish could eat ماذا حدث؟ What happened؟ سمكة كبيرة بلعت الدودة. بلعت swallowed. Okay. بلعت. نعم بلعت.
ماذا؟
How is it ending؟ بلعت.
Oh, it's another verb.
Exactly.
تاسكون.
Yeah, طيب. So, then what happened because of that?
She was surprised.
Yeah, ما هذا؟ So, the fish, the big fish is saying, the سمكة الكبيرة تقول is saying, ما هذا؟ Because it didn't know, it thought it's a duda, but it was actually a bait.
It came, it fell. Probably, that's what it thought, and then.
Exactly. ما هذا؟ السمكة الكبيرة خرجت من الماء. So it got pulled out, right? So it's very easy. So what happened? خرجت. What is خرجت?
Went out.
Coming out. Okay? So if you say خرجت من البيت, we learned in chapter in level 1 again. See all these things, there was a reason behind teaching this in level 1. Because we use this a lot. Okay? خرجت. It went. It came out. Or it went out. Okay? خرجت. I went out. خرج. He went out. خرجنا. We went out. طيب من الماء أخذت السمكة الصغيرة تسبح من جديد. أخذت. Remember we learned this in chapter 1. In story 1.
Oh, it's another verb?
Yeah, it's another verb. But what does it mean?
أخذت. Started.
Started. So literally, I know I keep mentioning this. Though it means took, I say أخذت الكتاب. I took the book. Okay, that's what it literally means. But if it comes before a verb, without going into too much of grammar rules, it means started. Okay, started to do that action. So in this case, what was the action?
تسبح.
Swimming.
She swims.
Yeah, so it started to swim. So if you say, أخذت السمكة الصغيرة تسبح, meaning it started to swim. Notice after أخذت, there is a verb.
مضارع.
Yeah, she started to swim. من جديد. What is من جديد? من جديد is an expression. It means again. Okay?
جديد also means new.
Yeah, من جديد together is an expression.
How did you get confused with that?
Yeah. So من جديد means again. Okay? طيب ماذا رأت? What did you see? Because it started swimming again. رأت فتات الخبز. فتات الخبز together means breadcrumbs. فتات الخبز. Over here, فتات becomes an object.
Food means crumbs, right?
No, bread.
No, bread.
And فتات means pieces.
Means pieces and like
okay?
crumbs.
Yeah. رأت فتات الخبز. What was happening? Was it going up?
It was going down.
يسقط. يسقط means falling. يسقط falling.
في الماء. It was falling in the water.
نعم. فتحت فمها. فتحت فمها. Again, notice.
فتحت.
We saw the previous page as well. فتحت فمها. وذهبت نحو الخبز. In the previous one, أين ذهبت السمكة نحو ماذا?
Oh,
in the direction of what? نعم. فتحت فمها. وذهبت نحو الخبز.
It went to the direction of the
in the خبز. Yeah.
The bread.
Previously, في how did it go? أين ذهبت؟ أي نحو؟
Direction of the earthquake.
نعم. Very good. Okay. صاحت السمكة. صاحت. Is it a verb or a noun? Again, notice.
It's a verb because it has the sukun.
Yeah, صاحت.
Sometimes it's not a verb because happy is an adjective.
No,
happy?
That's a different. It look ta marbuta, not ta sukun. Okay. So ta sukun means for now just take it as a verb. Okay. صاحت. صاحت meaning screaming, shouting. السمكة. Ah. Why did it? لماذا صاحت السمكة؟
I was scared. I was caught by a net.
Exactly. الشبكة حبستني.
Caught?
Yeah. حبس means to capture.
Mm-hmm.
A hold. Okay. حبستني.
حبستني الكتاب. You held the book.
No. You Wait. Use it usually to capture something. حبس.
You capture.
So if you want to say a hold, you say أمسكه.
You can see as in capture as well, so you capture the picture in your vision.
Yeah, again, yeah, again, yeah. So here, habasatni, ashabakatu, habasatni.
Habasatni.
So where is I over here? Captured me. Okay, so without going into the details, how do you say, Abdullah, my book?
Al-Kitabi?
Can you say Al-Kitabi. Kitabi. How do you say my pen?
Call me.